愿大家平安。
Peace to all brothers and sisters.
经过三年的时间，我们教会读经的进度已经要进入尾声，就是把启示录都读完了。
It's been 3 years, and we are almost to the end of the last book of the Bible, which is the book of Revelation.
如果过去大家三年当中有跟着读经的进度的话
，If you have been following our Bible reading schedule for the last 3 years,
恭喜你，你已经把圣经读了一遍。
Congratulations, you have read the Bible. From cover to cover already.
启示录是圣经最后一卷书。
The Book of Revelation is the last book of the Bible.
里面是讲主耶稣再来之前的会发生的事。
And it tells us what will happen prior to the coming of our Lord.
也是末世真教会的一个历史。
And it is a history of the true church prior to the end of the world.
那我们今天下午呢，要做一个总结。
And this afternoon, we are going to make a conclusion.
我们的题目是宝座前的两卷书。
And our topic is the two scrolls before the throne.
书有很多。
There are a lot of books.
大部分的书你看过，不一定对你有影响。
And most of the books that you have read may not impact you.
学校读的书，毕业了之后都忘记了。
And the books that you read in school, you'll probably forget them after you graduate.
但是在属灵上，灵界里面有两卷书。
But there are two books in the spiritual realm.
会影响你跟我的命运。
And it will impact our fate.
不单只是今生的命运。
Not only the fate of present life.
还有我们永生的命运。
And also the fate of our eternal life.
到底这两卷是什么书？
And what are these two books?
我们看启示录二十章十一节。
Let's turn to Revelation chapter 20 verse 11.
启示录二十章十一节。
Revelation chapter 20 verse 11.
我要看见一个白色的大宝座，与坐在上面的，从他面前天地都无逃避了，再无可见之处了。
Then I saw a great white throne and him who sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away, and there was found no place for them.
在启示录的最后的两章里面，约翰长老在灵里面看到主耶稣的白色的大宝座。
In the last two books of the book, in the last two chapters of Revelation, John saw the great white throne of our Lord Jesus.
就像刚刚会前我们唱了一首诗一样。
Likened to the hymnal that we sang earlier.
如果主耶稣今天就来，我们就要面对主了。
If our Lord Jesus would come today, we have to face him today.
我们就要面对他的审判。
We have to face his judgment.
那主耶稣呢？他是万主之主，万王之王。
Our Lord Jesus is King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
审判的时候，他要坐在他的宝座上面。
And when it's judgment time, he will sit on his throne.
但是主耶稣这个宝座跟地上的王的宝座不一样。
The throne of our Lord Jesus is different from the thrones of the kings of the earth.
灵里面他的宝座是白色的。
In the spiritual realm, the throne of our Lord is white.
白色代表圣洁。
White represents purity.
那主耶稣就坐在上边，要审判世上历史以来每一个人。
And our Lord Jesus will be sitting on this throne to judge everyone from the beginning of time.
我们要留意这里所写的，到那个时候啊，从他面前天地都逃避，但是没有可以逃的地方了。
And please take note that from whose face the earth and heaven were fled away, and there was found no place for them.
我们知道，如果你抓老鼠，哇，你打开灯，老鼠啊，蟑螂啊，看到你它会跑啊，躲在一些地方，你找不到它。
If you know that you're catching a rat or a cockroach, once you turn on the lights, all the rats and the cockroaches would fly away from your presence.
你可以想象，当你把所有的家具、所有的杂物都拿出去，它就没有地方可以逃了。
But if you were to take away all the furniture in the room, then there's no place for the rats and the cockroaches to hide.
就是你一定可以抓到它。
And you will be able to catch them.
今天很多人都在逃避神。
Today, a lot of people are fleeing away from God.
不相信有神。
They don't believe in Him.
为什么不相信有神？
Why not?
除了他们的骄傲之外。
Besides their pride.
他们觉得我相信没有神，我就不用面对神。
They felt, or rather, they believe that if God does not exist, then they will not have to face His judgment.
我做什么？没有，我不需要跟任何人负责。
That I don't have to be responsible to anyone.
所以很多人选择相信没有神。
So a lot of people choose to be atheists.
让他自己的良心可能过得好一点。
So that their conscience may have a better time.
哎呀，这一辈子过了就过了，哪有什么天国地狱，哪有什么神。
If my present life passed, then let it pass. There is no heaven, there is no earth.
这种人是自己骗自己。
These people are lying to themselves.
你今天可以逃避神，但是以后你逃避不了神。
You may be able to flee away from God today, but in the future, you will not be able to flee away.
就像学生，你可以不去上课，你可以翘课。
Like students, you may be able to skip classes.
但是你没有办法面对 你那个 final grade， 你最后多少成绩啊
？But you will not be able to face your final result for that course。
最后能不能毕业？你能够把逃避吗
？Can you run away from your graduation？
没得逃避的。
No, you can't。
所以不要选择逃避神。
So let us choose not to flee away from God。
圣经里面有一个人叫做约拿。
There is a person in the Bible by the name of Jonah。
圣经说他躲避神。
The Bible says that he fled away from God.
神叫他去东，他就坐船往西。
And God wanted him to head east. He took a trip and headed west.
但是他逃避不了神啊。
But he could not flee away from God.
在海中间，神都把他抓回来。
And when he was in the middle of the sea, the God captured him.
所以不如我们提早面对神。
So let us why not face God early?
啊，等到将来你被抓回来，勉强面对神，那个时候已经太慢了。
Because by the time you were captured by God to face Him, it would have been too late.
有一个弟兄，他这样子警告，也可以说勉励他的孩子。
There was a brother who encouraged or warned his children.
他告诉他孩子，你人生什么都不重要，最重要是神。
He told his children, "What's most important in your life is God."
你绝对不可以离开神。
You can never depart from God.
除非你自己觉得你自己永远不会死。
Unless you feel that you will live for eternity.
这句话挺有道理的。
It seems quite reasonable.
你可以离开神，如果你不死的话。
If you deem that you will never die, then you can depart from God.
你就不用面对神呢。
Because you don't have to face Him.
但是你会不会死
？But will you die?
当然会死啊。
Absolutely.
迟早的问题而已。
It's only a matter of time.
所以每个人不要选择逃避。
So let us choose not to run away.
很可惜，今天有一些弟兄姐妹也是选择逃避。
Unfortunately, a lot of brothers and sisters today choose to flee away.
明明父母都把他生在教会里面，带在教会里面，养在教会里面。
Their parents have already brought them into church, raised them in the church.
父母都已经尽了责任，给他拿去受洗啊，宗教教育。
The parents had done their share, or rather their duty, by baptizing them in the church, bringing them to religious education classes.
但是长大，他就远离了神了。
However, when these children were grown up, they choose to flee away from God.
好，在这个大宝座面前，有两卷书跟我们的命运有绝对的关系。
And before this great white throne, there are two scrolls that ties to our fate.
第一卷书叫做暗卷。
The first is the dark scroll.
我们看启示录二十章十二节。
Let's turn to Revelation chapter 20 verse 12.
启示录二十章十二节。
Chapter 20 verse 12.
请读。
And I saw the dead, small and great, standing before God, and books were opened, and another book was opened, which is the book of life, and the dead were judged according to their works by the things which were written in the books.
第一卷书跟我们全人类有关系的叫做案卷。
The first book that ties to our fate is a scroll.
其实不是一卷，是很多很多卷，因为这个世界有很多很多人。
It's not one scroll, but rather it's many scrolls.
到时候审判的时候已经开始了。
At that time, the judgment of God has already started.
神坐在宝座上。
And our Lord is sitting on His throne.
那他审判的时候要有一些资料啊。
And when He judged, He needed some information.
当然，道理真理是不改变的。
Of course, the truth never changes.
这是每一个人他有没有按照真理而行。
But has everyone done according to the truth?
所以神要怎么审判
？So how does God judge?
神要把很多很多卷拿出来，换你来的时候，就把你的那个 file， 你的那个资料档就拿出来。
So God has to go through many books to look for your particular file.
啊，从你出生的第一秒钟开始。
From the second that you were born into the world.
到你死那一刻的最后一秒钟。
Until the minute or the second that you give up your last breath.
你的人生有多长，这个案卷的记录有多少
？And however long your life is. That would be however much information is recorded in those books.
所以这些要死了的人呢，就要凭着这个案卷所记载的，神要来审判他们。
And God shall judge the dead according to the things that were written in the books.
就好像你去法庭，你是被告了。
For example, if you go to the court and you are an accused.
啊，有人告你，那有检察官告你，他会准备很多资料啊。
And you are being accused or you're being sued, then the prosecutor will collect a lot of information on you.
比如说你冲了一个红灯了。
For example, you ran a red light.
啊，领了一个罚单了。
So you have been fined.
你说我没有冲红灯。
And you claim that you're innocent, you have run a red light.
那个是黄灯。
That was only a yellow light.
结果检察官拿出来那个 video 录出来，这里明明就是红灯，你冲过去。
And the prosecutor may have shown a video of you running the red light.
啊，还有了很多人的见证写下来了。
And the witnesses, the accounts of the witnesses.
你不承认也没有用。
So even if you deny it, it's pointless.
因为写得清清楚楚。
Because things have been written down very clearly.
我们的一生，虽然我们不知道，其实神每分每秒都在看我们。
Even though we may be unknowing to us, our Lord Jesus is looking at us every second, every minute.
有一天，我们都要面对我们所做过的事情的。
One day we have to face the things that we have done.
我们都要复活的。
We will revive.
有人以为说信了耶稣才会复活。
Some people believe that only those who believe in Christian, only those who believe in the Lord Jesus will revive.
其实不是。
That is not true.
你没有信耶稣，你也会复活。
Even if you're not a Christian, you will also be raised from the dead.
只是被定罪而已。
Except that you will be sentenced.
我们看约翰五章二十八节。
Let's turn to John chapter 5 verse 28.
约翰福音五章二十八二十九节。
Gospel John chapter 5 verse 28. Do not marvel at this, for the hour is coming which all who are in the graves will hear his voice. 29. And come forth those who have done good to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to the resurrection of condemnation.
这里讲得很清楚，无论你有信或是没有信，到了主耶稣末世号通来的时候，你都要复活。
And it's very clear here that whether you are a Christian or not, when the time comes, you will be raised from the dead.
我很喜欢去墓园散步走路。
I like to take a walk in the cemetery.
哇，那些墓园啊，看看每一个人站在那边啊，活了多久，看看他的墓碑。
By looking at the tombstones, I'm able to see how long the deceased had lived on earth.
人生的结局，地上的身体就要在墓园。
And the ending of life is your body being placed under the earth in a cemetery.
那很多都会写 RIP 哈 ，Rest in peace， 就是啊，让你安息。
And on a lot of the tombstones, you will see the letters RIP, which means rest in peace.
但是真的是安息吗
？But have they truly found peace and rest?
是不是坟墓就是人生的终结
？So is the end of life a grave?
不是的。
No.
当主耶稣来的时候
，When our Lord Jesus comes,
全部死人都要出来。
All who are dead will be raised from the dead.
埋在坟墓里的，这坟墓要交出来。
And those who have been buried in the graves, they will come out of the graves.
死在海里的还要交出来。
And those who died in the ocean, they will come out from the ocean.
都要面对审判。
Everyone has to face judgment.
行善的，就是要复活得生。
And those who have done well, they will resurrect and enjoy eternal life.
作恶的，就要复活定罪。
And those who have done evil, they will resurrect to condemnation.
我在走墓园的时候，都会想象，哇，那一天末日浩通来了，所有要都全部死人都要跑出来。
And when I was walking in the graveyard, I would start to imagine what it would be like if everyone were to rise from the dead and be judged.
还有呢，每一个人所做的每一件事，神都已经写在他的档案里面，将来要拿出来给你看。
And everything that we have done in our lives have been recorded in the book.
其实有时候我们忘记自己做的事情。
In fact, there are times we have forgotten what we have done.
但是听说了，在你死之前，有时候会那个记忆啊，全部会跑出来一趟。
But I heard that prior to death, your life will flash before your eyes.
我听过一个见证。
I have heard testimonies, these kind of testimonies.
有个弟兄有一次在开车。
There was a brother who was driving.
哇，发生很大的意外。
He had a major auto accident.
那个车子一直在打转。
The vehicle was spinning.
他感觉到他这一次快死了。
He felt that he was about to die.
车子这样失控，他应该会死掉。
And that he has lost control of his car and he's about to die.
在他感觉到快要死之前
，When he felt that he was just about to die,
他很害怕。
He had great fear.
但是头脑里面呢，好像电影一样，把他从小到大做过很多不好的事情，全部好像电影放给他看。
But in his mind, he's seeing pictures of all the bad things they have done from the time he was a young child.
那个车子高速公路是失控了，可能只有一两秒而已啊。
And losing control of a car on a highway was only for about 2 to 3 seconds.
但是在他那个灵里面啊，我在那个看那个电影很长很长，从小做过的坏事全部放出来。
But in the spirit, he seems to be watching a movie of his life.
他很害怕，他说我这样肯定下地狱。
He was in great fear. He felt that he would be going down to hell for sure.
虽然他是个信徒，但是那么多不好的行为。
Even though he was a member of the church, but he has so much misconduct.
他向神悔改啊。
He repented to God.
那一次车祸，他竟然没死。
And he didn't die from that accident.
他说：“哎呀，真的要悔改。”
And he said to himself, "I must truly repent."
原来我们所做的所有事情，不单只记在我们的最深层的头脑里面，还有在神的档案里。
The things that we have done are not only recorded in our deepest memory, but also recorded in God's books.
所以圣经也警告我们。
So the Bible is warning us.
我们看 传道书十一章第九节。
Let's turn to Ecclesiastes chapter 11 verse 9.
传道书十一章的九节。
Ecclesiastes chapter 11 verse 9. Rejoice, O young man, in your youth, and let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. Walk in the ways of your heart and in the sight of your eyes, but know that for all these, God will bring judgment. God will bring you into judgment.
啊，很多人看圣经看一半。
A lot of people read the Bible halfway.
他会喜欢第一句，少年人啊，应当趁着年幼的时候快乐。
They like the first phrase, "Rejoice, O young man, in your youth."
就好像现在的那种思想啊 ，Don't worry, be happy. 不要想那么多。年轻的时候就是要快乐。
It's likened to what is trending in the world right now. Don't worry and be happy.
啊，这个是当时也有的那种观念。
This is the same concept that exists in those days.
啊，当然不是只有年轻人。
Of course, not only the young men.
现在很多人都是尽量就是快乐。
And today, a lot of people try to find happiness whenever they can.
只是年轻人比较放任，比较放荡。
It's just that the youth tend to be more open about it.
他想看东西，他要去看。
If they want to see something, they will go ahead and see it.
啊，譬如说，网络上面很多东西看。
For example, there are a lot of things that you can watch online.
很多色情的东西啊。
A lot of pornography.
看那个东西很快乐啊。
And if those bring you joy, they will enjoy it.
啊，心里面想做什么
？And whatever they think that they want to do in their hearts.
开 party 啊。
They will party.
男女关系乱搞啊。
And they would fornicate.
喝酒啊。
They would drink.
抽大麻。
They would smoke marijuana.
啊，那行你所心所愿的。
They would do what their hearts desire.
看你所想要看的。
They would watch what they desire.
这里传道者说：“好啊，你可以啊，但是你要知道一件事。”
In this verse, it says, "Yes, you can do that, but know this."
所有的你做的这一切，神到最后在审判桌前会问你啊，会审问你。
Know that for all these that you have done, God will bring you into judgment.
你在最隐藏、关起门来、大家都看不见的事，神要把那天的审判大日全部给你公开。
The things that you have hidden from everyone, God will bring them to light on the day of judgment.
还有用这个东西来审判，来决定你能不能得救。
And He will use these to decide whether you can be saved.
如果我们想起这一节，我们做事情的时候就好好想一想。
If you remember this verse well, then whatever you do, you have to ponder and think over.
神不会让任何一件事情轻易的被逃过、被忘记的。
God will not let you go free from all the evil things you have done.
所以我们要趁着年轻要做什么
？So while you were young, what you should do?
啊，要趁着年轻来寻求神啊。
While you were young, you should seek God.
这是刚刚我们所读的，我们继续来读第十节，《传道书》十一章的第十节。
Continue on with Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 11. Therefore, remove sorrow from your heart and put away evil from your flesh, for childhood and youth are vanity.
好，这里说了，我们要把那些不好的欲望全部要拿走。
So let us remove all the evil desires from your heart.
不然的话，你那个档案就很难看了、啊，你那个案卷就很难看、啊。
Otherwise, your record will look awful.
写那么多不好的东西在里面，以后怎么样在面对神呢
？So much bad things about you recorded in those books. How will you face God on that judgment day?
那这个是比较消极的，就是不要去犯罪或者改戒掉坏习惯。
And this is a very passive way of dealing things. That is, don't do bad things.
啊，积极一点呢，就是要趁着年轻的时候追求神，追求信仰。
To be more proactive, you should be seeking God while you are still young.
不单只是说我们的档案不要被神写那些不好的东西。
Not only we should not allow God, or rather we should not let God write all those evil things about us in the books.
我们要让神可以有意义的、可以赏赐我们的东西写在上面啊。
But rather we should bring God to light by doing things that would please God, so that those would be recorded in the books.
我很喜欢这个图啊，就是问 Why should youth? 为什么年轻人有什么东西年轻人要追求的？
I like this picture because it asks the question, what should youth pursue in life?
人生有三个阶段。
There are three stages of life.
小时候就是追着玩啊。
When you were young, you're pursuing for pleasure.
啊，然后读书。
Or studies.
然后呢，毕业。
And when you graduate.
好了，之后就找女朋友了。
Then after that, you will be looking for a spouse.
啊，这个是头三十年。
That is your first 30 years.
这个是年轻的时候。
That is your youth.
啊，这三十岁到六十岁就是中年的时候。
From the age 30 to 60 is a middle life.
结婚生孩子。
You get married, you have children.
追求事业。
You pursue a career.
啊，忙着照顾小孩家庭。
And you'll be busy taking care of your children and your family.
那孩子大了，你就开始拿拐杖了，你就老了。
And when your children have grown up, you would be holding on to a cane because you have aged.
啊，那到第三个阶段就是老年期，60到90岁。
And your third stage in life is the elderly from the age 60 to 90.
啊， 两夫妻感情再好，有一个一定要先走。
No matter how good, how lovely a couple is, one of them probably will go first.
啊，一个就守在墓旁边。
And the other will be keeping by the side of the tomb.
到最后，两个都走了，就两个墓碑在那边。
At the end, and the other spouse would die also and ended up with two tombstones.
这很实际啊。
This is reality.
你再大的成就，你也跑不过这个三个阶段。
No matter how much achievements you have gained in life, you will not escape these three stages.
你有多少钱，你也跑不过这三个阶段。
No matter how much money you have earned, you will not escape from these three stages.
但是圣经说，你不要等到年老七老八十的时候才来找神，才来追求信仰。
But the Bible tells us that do not start looking for God when you are in your 70s and your 80s.
当然，有一些人是神在很老年的时候才拣选他。
Of course, there are people who were chosen by God at a later stage in life.
但是如果你是从小生在教会里面，父母都是信主的。
However, if you were born into the church and your parents were members,
你就不要走那个冤枉路了。
Then let us not walk that unnecessary route.
不要浪费头五六十年了。
Let us not waste our first 50 or 60 years.
不要等到受很多苦才要回来。
Do not return to God after you have suffered much.
趁年轻的时候就把人生的方向抓住。
So seize the correct direction while you are still in your youth.
让你的这个档案里面呢，满满的神可以帮你写。哎呀，你的信仰很好，要追求神，服侍神，在教会里面长大。
So that your records with God are good, that you have been serving God since you were young.
你就没有浪费任何的时间去虚空啊，去后悔。
And you have not wasted any time spent on vanity.
任何时候你面对神，你都不怕。
So that whatever time it is, or whatever stage it is in your life, you will not be afraid to face God.
神就按照你所做的行为，当最后审判你。哎，可以，这个孩子好，我喜欢。
And God will judge you according to your conduct, and by looking at your record, He will say that I am pleased with this child.
看这个《传道书》十二章十三节。
Let's turn to Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13.
传道书十二章十三节十四节。
Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13 and verse 14. 13. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep His commandments, for this is man's all. 14. For God will bring every work into judgment, including every secret thing, whether good or evil.
这里告诉我们，最重要要敬畏神，就是要怕神。
It says here that of all things, we have to fear God.
怕神就不敢去犯罪。
If you fear God, you will not dare to commit evil.
今天很多人要怕病毒，但是不怕神。
Today, a lot of people fear the virus, the COVID-19 virus, but do not fear God.
很多人怕死，但是不怕神。
A lot of people fear death, but do not fear God.
我们最重要的其实只有怕神，其他都不用怕。
For us, the most important thing is to fear God and nothing else.
死就死了，迟早都要死的。
If I die, I die because I have to face death sooner or later.
如果有永生的等我们，那怕什么
？However, there is eternal life waiting for us after we die.
最怕就是没有得救，没有把握。
What we fear most is that we have no salvation and we have no hope.
或者是你的信仰一塌糊涂。
Or that your faith is terrible.
没有在守诫命。
You have not kept the commandments of God.
我们人很在意别人怎么看我。
We value others' opinion of us.
我们放东西上社交媒体，就希望多少个人给我们赞。
We put things onto social network, hoping to earn a few thumbs ups or praises from our peers.
我们看下一张图啊。
Let's take a look at the next slide.
我们问了，到底神怎么样说我们呢
？Let us understand how God is judging us.
你上面的这个档案写什么
？What will your record say about you?
神是一直给你这个好，还是神一直给你说不行
？Will God give you a thumbs up, or will He give you a thumbs down?
连我们在聚会哦，神都在观察我们呢。
Even when we are in service, God is observing us.
现在是下午嘛，这一节有一些人上午听了，下午要就没有聚会了。
And right now is in the afternoon. There are some members who only attend the morning service and not the afternoon.
你看看那个，现在是看不到了。看看那个 view 啊，下午那个都比上午少了。
If you were to take a look at the number of people watching right now, the number is probably lower than this morning.
有一部分信徒早上听了，哦，下午我就不听了，我就不聚会。
Some members felt that they have attended the service in the morning, so they will not be watching in the afternoon.
神都派天使来点名了。
God sent His angels to take attendance.
最近听了一个读了一个见证。
I have recently read a testimony.
有一位国小一年级的学生啊，在台湾啊，哇，他在祷告会里面看到异象。
And there was a young child in grade 1 in Taiwan and who saw a vision in his prayers.
他在祷告的时候很努力求圣灵。
When he was praying for his for the Holy Spirit.
祷告里面让他主耶稣打开了眼睛，看到主耶稣还有六位天使啊出现。
When he was praying, he saw a vision. He opened his eyes and saw Jesus along with six angels.
加起来就七位了。
So altogether seven.
那他们走在白色的天梯上面。
They were walking on white ground.
主耶稣双手举起，大声的念，奉主耶稣圣名祷告。
The Lord Jesus raised up both his hands and said in a loud voice, "In the name of Jesus, we pray."
然后就开始帮每一位弟兄姐妹在会堂的人按手。And
then he laid hands on everybody in the chapel.
有一位第一位天使也在帮忙按手祷告。And
the first angel was also laying hands on the members.
第二位天使呢，他很严肃的在观察。The
second angel was gravely observing.
看到一个老弟兄在祷告的时候啊，不专心，睁开眼睛。
He saw an elder brother not paying attention in his prayers, and he was opening his eyes.
天使的眼睛就睁很大，盯着那个老弟兄。And
the angel opened up his eyes and stared at the elderly brother.
还有天使呢，还飞来飞去看每一个信徒怎么聚会，怎么祷告。
There were angels flying around the room, observing the members and how they were praying.
第三个天使呢？The
third angel.
哦，他在会堂最前边拿着一本本子在记录。
In his hand was a book, and he was recording things at the front of the chapel.
哇，看看哪一个每一个聚会的状态的记录。He
was observing the state of every member in the room.
那第四个天使呢？The
fourth angel.
在会堂的下方后面也在记录。He
was standing at the back of the room and taking attendance.
哇，一前一后啊，就包起来了。So
one in the front, one at the back.
不止这样啊，第五个天使在做什么？What
was the fifth angel doing?
他坐在弟兄姐妹的位置旁边。
He was sitting beside the members.
每一个弟兄姐妹聚会的样子，他都看一看。He
was observing every brother and sister when they were attending.
有时候啊，弟兄姐妹坐在位置还可以骗传道。And
there are times that members, when they're sitting in the pews, they're able to deceive the preacher.
怎么骗？很好骗嘛。How
do they deceive? It's very easy.
他把圣经拿出来。They
would take the Bible.
手机呢，夹在圣经里面。
And the cell phone is right on top of the Bible.
这样我就好像看圣经，传道看着我在拿圣经，其实里面呢在滑手机。
So to the preacher, it looks like the member was reading the Bible. However, the member was actually playing with their cell phone.
你可以骗传道，但是你骗不过天使。
You may be able to deceive the preacher, but you cannot deceive the angels.
你头的低着也骗不过天使，天使坐在你旁边，给你看，给你报告给主耶稣。
Even if you have your head laid low, you will still not be able to deceive the angels because the angels are sitting right next to you.
所以第五个天使这样子在坐在信徒的旁边看着，盯着。So
the fifth angel was sitting beside the members and observing.
第六个天使呢，在会堂绕来绕去，绕来绕去。And
the sixth angel was walking up and down in the chapel.
最重要的，这个小孩子看到主耶稣在会堂里面帮每一个信徒按手。
But the most important thing is that this child saw that the Lord Jesus was laying hands on every member of the
church.当然了，专心的才按了，那个不专心的，可能主耶稣要跳过了。And
of course, our Lord Jesus was only laying hands on those who were paying attention. For those who weren't, he would skip them.
所以连聚会的时候，主耶稣都帮我们观察，天使都在写在本子上面。So
even during services, the angels and our Lord Jesus were observing us and recording our conduct.
你平常每一个举动，你网上看了什么，出去外面跟什么人在一起，讲了什么，想了什么，主耶稣也全部写下来。So
where you go, what you do, what you were thinking, and what you were watching, it's all of these were recorded by our Lord Jesus and His angels.
现在信徒虽然不在会堂，在家里聚会。So
even though members are not gathering in the church, but rather at home,
主耶稣也在派天使来看你啊，有没有在聚会啊？Our
Lord Jesus is also sending His angels to observe you, whether you're paying attention.
是不是躺在沙发就睡着了？Are
you lying down on your sofa sleeping?
不是不专心。Are
you paying attention?
天使都在记录。
The angels are recording it.
有时候，如果主耶稣给我们看一看他记录了什么啊，我们可能会很尴尬，会很羞愧。
And if we were shown our record by our Lord Jesus, perhaps we will be so ashamed.
我们可能会请求主耶稣啊，能不能把它撕掉，把它delete掉啊？我不想看到，我原来我 行为那么差。
And perhaps we would even request our Lord Jesus to erase our records because the contents were so bad.
所以我们不用看，不用在乎别人怎么看。
So let us not care about what others think of us.
我们要在乎主耶稣怎么看我们。
Rather, we have to pay attention to what our Lord Jesus say about us.
你这个 file， 你这个案件，主耶稣帮你写了什么？
What is recorded in your record?
希望都不是太差的东西。
We hope that it is nothing too terrible.
好，第二卷书。
The second scroll
更重要的
，more important，
这个叫生命册。
This is the book of life。
我们看启示录二十章十二节。
Let's turn to Revelation chapter 20 verse 12。
启示录二十章十二节。
Revelation chapter 20 verse 12. And I saw the dead, small and great, standing before God, and books were opened. And another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged according to their works by the things which were written in the books.
那第二卷书呢，在审判台前呢，叫做生命册。
So the second book, before God, is the book of life.
顾名思义，这一卷册是跟生命有关系的。
As the name suggested, this book has to do with life.
你的名字有记载在上面，将来才可以有永远的生命。
If your name is recorded in that book, then in the future.You will receive salvation.
才可以进天国的意思。
You will only be able to enter into heavenly kingdom.
第一卷书是记录你的行为。
The first book records your conduct.
第二卷书就是决定你能不能得救。
The second book decides whether you can be saved.
哇，那如果你在上面有名字的话，那你可以松一口气。
If your name is found in the book of life, you can breathe a sigh of relief.
那如果你名字没有在上面的话，你就不能得救了。
However, if your name is not found in the book, you will not receive salvation.
所以我们要问自己的问题：我的名字有记录在生命册上面吗？
Let us ask ourselves: Is my name recorded in the book of life?
你的名字有没有在名校毕业？那个不重要。
Whether your name is recorded in the book of graduation.It does not matter.
你没有拿到地上某一个国家的身份，也不是最重要。
If you have not obtained citizenship of a certain country in the world, it doesn't matter.
你的名字要在生命册上面才重要。
What is more important is your name to be found in the book of life.
像今天去打疫苗，很多人都想要打疫苗，对不对？
For example, a lot of people wanted to get vaccinated today.
你要登记才有办法打。
You have to register first before you are injected.
你不能就走进去的时候你要打就打。
You cannot walk into a clinic and ask for an injection.
你没有先登记，你的名字有没有系统里面
？You have to first register to see if your name can be found in the system.
啊，疫苗只是今生的健康的问题而已。
The vaccination is only for your present life.
在这里，生命册有没有名字
？But is your name found in the book of life?
啊，有人说了，没问题，传道，我从小就受洗了。
There's some people who said to me, "No problem, preacher. I've been baptized in the church since young."
我小时候也灵恩会求到圣灵。
And I have received the Holy Spirit when I was a child.
啊，我的名字早就在生命册上面。
My name is already in the book of life.
啊，没有错，我们的名字可能很早就写在生命册上。
It is true that our name may have been recorded in the book of life earlier.
但是不要太高兴。
But let us not rejoice too early.
你的名字写在生命册上，不代表它永远会在生命册上。
Your name being in the book of life does not mean that it will remain there forever.
不是保证的。
It is not a guarantee.
如果我们没有守道理
，If you have not observed the truth or keep the truth，
神可以随时把我们名字把它擦掉。
God can always erase our name from that book.
就像以前的老师都是用那个粉笔啊，写在黑板上面，那个很好擦，一擦就没有了。
In the past, teachers would use chalk and chalkboards, and it's very easy to erase.
今天我们的名字也是暂时写在生命册上。
Today, our name is only temporarily written in the book of life.
随时可以被擦掉。
It can be erased anytime.
我们看启示录三章五节。启示录第三章第五节。
Revelation chapter 3 verse 5.
启示录三章五节。
Revelation chapter 3 verse 5.
第五节。
5. He who overcomes shall be clothed in white garments. I will not blot out his name from the book of life, but I will confess his name before my Father and before his angels.
就是圣灵对一个很软弱的教会撒迪教会所讲的话。
Here is what the Holy Spirit said to the church in Sardis.
这个教会很差劲。
This is a terrible church.
第三章第一节就说了，这个教会按名是活的，其实已经死了。
In chapter 3, verse 1, it says, By name, this church is alive, but actually, it is dead.
名字是一个基督徒，其实行为不是一个基督徒。
By name, there are Christians. However, by conduct, they're not.
这些人，他的名字原来在生命册，但是早就被主耶稣擦掉了。
And these members, their names were originally in the book of life. However, God has blotted out their names.
但是剩下一点点，剩下几个人。
And only a few were kept on the book.
他们的行为没有学习那些其他的坏的榜样。
They have not imitated the conduct of the others.
他们得胜。
They have found victory.
所以圣灵保证他们，你得胜，我就不查你的名字。
And the Holy Spirit guarantee that their names will be kept in the book of life.
如果不查你的名字，将来你在父神面前才会被承认。
And if their names were not blotted out from the book of life, then in the future, Lord Jesus will confess their names before God and before His angels.
这句话很吓人哦，很恐怖哦。
This sounds rather terrifying.
你不要以为你的名字在真耶稣教会的信徒名簿上面，你就能够得救。Do
not think that because your name is found in the register of True Jesus Church that you will be saved.
信徒名簿有名，你有洗礼。
Your name is found in the church registry because you have been baptized.
不代表你的名字还在生命册上面。However,
it does not mean that your name can be found in the book of life.
听过一个见证，哇，让我想了很久。
I've heard a testimony that caused me to ponder quite a bit.
有个青年呢，他虽然从小信主，但是他信仰非常软弱。
There was a youth. He had believed in the Lord since young, but he is very weak.
来教会就迟到，常常睡觉或者玩手机。
He will be late come to church, and he will be playing with his cell phones and games when he is in church.
有一天是灵恩会。
One day during spiritual convocation.
在圣餐礼的时候。
During Holy Communion.
他也是打瞌睡。
He fell asleep.
连跪在那边注谢的时候，他也在打瞌睡。
Even when he was kneeling down, while saying words of consecration, he fell asleep.
因为他之前晚上整个晚上都没睡觉啊，在上网啊，打电动啊，看一些不好的。
Because the night before, he was actually up all night watching stuff on the internet.
聚会当然没精神啊。And
that is why he is very tired when he came to church.
连圣餐注谢圣餐饼的时候都睡着。
Even when consecrating the bread during spiritual convocation, or rather during Holy Communion, he would fall asleep.
主耶稣让他看异象。
But the Lord Jesus gave him a vision.
他来到天堂的门口。
He came to the door of the heavenly kingdom.
想要进去天国。
He wanted to go in.
那天使挡着。
But the angel blocked his way.
问他你是谁。
Angels asked him, "Who are you?"
我说某某某啊，我从小信主的。
And he said, "I am so and so, and I believe in the Lord since I was young."
天使说，等一下，我要查一查你的名字有没有在上面。
And the angel told him to wait. He has to check.
他说有了，你放心，一定有。我从小信了，我每个礼拜都来教会。
And the brother said to the angel, "Yes, you will definitely find my name in the book because I go to church every week."
那天使就开始翻了。
And so the angel was flipping through the pages.
一页一页的翻。
Page by page.
哎，都没有这个弟兄的名字。
That his name did not appear anywhere.
哎，首先翻到是他妈妈的名字。
The first thing that the angel found was his mother's name.
他妈妈也是信徒嘛。
And his mother was a member too.
他妈妈名字有在里面。
So his mother's name was in the book.
但是上面写着啊，这个人没有做圣工。
But it's noted that she did not do any holy work.
但是这个弟兄的名字还没被找到。
And yet this brother's name was not found.
啊，他就开始紧张了。
So he started to get nervous.
拜托天使，再看看，一定有了，你帮我找找看。
Can you check again? It has to be on there. Check again.
啊，天使一直翻到很后面。
So the angel keep checking the book and flipping through pages.
都没有他名字。
His name was not found there.
他开始冒汗了。 So
he started to sweat.
哇，到他差不多翻到最后一两页。
Finally to the final two pages.
哦，天使说，是不是这个名？
And the angel asked him, "Is this your name?"
哎，是我的名字。
And he said, yes, this is my name.
哇，他松了一口气。So
he sighed in relief.
哇，还好我的名字还在上面。
Thank God my name is still in it.
只是他在看到他名字的时候。
Except when he saw his name.
那个名字好像被人家擦，开始擦掉，越来越模糊。
He saw that his name is starting to get blurrier and blurrier, and as if somebody is erasing it.
差不多认不出他的名字来了。Almost
to a point that he cannot recognize his name.
他的名字开始消失了。His
name started to disappear.
哇，他就很紧张啊，不要，不要，不要消失。And
he was very nervous. Don't disappear.
哇，全身冒汗。He
was sweating all over.
啊，才从异象里面再醒过来。
And he woke up from his vision.
刚好注谢结束，阿门。And
the bread has been consecrated.
哇，他吓死了。He
was terrified.
他想起自己的行为。He
started to recall his conduct.
自己的软弱，自己所犯的罪。His
weakness, the sins he had committed.
原来我的名字已经被擦得差不多了。He
realized that his name is almost completely blotted out.
剩没几画了，擦得差不多了。
There was only a few lines left of his name.
原来圣经的话是真的，你的名字可以被擦掉。
So what is recorded in the Bible is true. Your name can be erased from the book of life.
旧约里面也有讲。
This is also recorded in the Old Testament.
我们看出埃及记32章32节。
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 32, verse 32.
出埃及记32章32节。
Exodus chapter 32, verse 32.
32章32节。
Exodus chapter 32, verse 32. Yet now, if you will forgive their sin, but if not, I pray, blot me out of your book which you have written.
33节。
And the Lord said to Moses, whoever has sinned against me, I will blot him out of my book.
哇，原来真的是这样子啊。
So it is true.
摩西啊，那个时候向神为了百姓祷告。
Moses, for the sake of his people, prayed to the Lord.
因为百姓得罪神啊，神不要百姓进迦南地，要全部毁灭他们。
Because the people of Israel had sinned against God, and God did not want them to enter into the land of Canaan, wanted to destroy them all.
摩西很爱百姓，就为他们祷告。
And Moses loved his people and prayed for them.
他说：“神啊，你赦免他们的罪。”
And Moses prayed to God to forgive their sins.
他就有点点点点点哦，就是一种沉默的挣扎。
And there are some dots there representing. There's a dash there representing that there's a struggle, a silent struggle.
摩西就跟神做一个交易了。他想说：“好了，交换个条件。”
So Moses made a deal with God.
如果你不赦免他们，那你把我的名字从生命册上面就涂抹掉了。
If you will not forgive them, then blot me out of your book of life.
意思就是说，如果百姓不能得救，我也不想得救了。
Meaning that if the people cannot be saved, then I don't want to be saved either.
但是呢，神怎么说？
However, what did God reply?
谁得罪我，我就从我的册上涂抹谁的名。
God said, whoever has sinned against me, I will blot him out of my book.
我不会乱涂人的名的。
I will not casually erase people's name.
儿子犯罪不会涂掉爸爸的名。
If the son has sinned, I will not erase the father's name.
妈妈犯罪也不会涂掉女儿的名。
If the mother has sinned, I will not erase the daughter's name.
谁得罪我，我就涂谁的名。
Who sinned against me, I will erase their
names. 神可以把你的名加上去，神也可以把你的名涂抹掉。
If God can write your name into the book, He can erase your name from the book.
所以这个是值得我们反省思考。
This is a point worthy for us to think over.
也许我们的名字已经被擦得差不多了。
Perhaps our name has been almost erased.
赶紧悔改，主啊，赦免我，赶紧把我的名字加回去。
Then let us quickly repent ourselves so that God can add our names back into the book.
不要像下一个图这样，到最后我们在审判台前。
Do not be likened to the cartoon here that on the day of judgment.
我们求神说，神啊，我要得救。神说，打开生命册看一看。天使说，没有嘞，这个人的名字没有在上面。
We pray to God to save us, and God will say, "Open the book of life." While the angel answer, then our name is not in the book.
这个是值得我们思考的问题啊。
This is a point worthy for us to think over and over.
好，谁的名字会被涂走、被涂抹呢
？Whose name will be erased?
我们看。启示录第九章的20节21节。
Let's turn to Revelation chapter 9, verse 20 and verse 21.
启示录九章二十节二十一节。
The book of Revelation chapter 9, verse 20 and verse 21. But the rest of mankind who were not killed by these plagues did not repent of the works of their hands, that they should not worship demons and of idols of gold, silver, brass, stone, and wood, which can neither see nor hear nor walk.
21节。
21. And they did not repent of their murders or their sorceries or their sexual immorality or their thefts.
这里记载有一些不能得救的人，他们做了什么事情。
And here it tells us of the people who cannot be saved and what they had done.
他们第一就是拜魔鬼，就是拜偶像。
First, they worship demons.
拜那个金啊、银啊、铜铁所做的。
They worship idols of gold, silver, brass, stone, and wood.
再来呢，他们是凶杀的。
Next, they were murderers.
邪术的。
They practice sorcery.
奸淫的。
They practice sexual immorality.
偷窃的。
And they steal.
这些人是不能得救的。
These people cannot be saved.
好了，如果一个信主的人做的事情跟这些一模一样。
If a Christian does the same thing as these people,
当然了，他的名字是绝对会被抹掉的。
And of course, their names will be erased from the book of life.
刚刚我们讲那个见证那个小弟兄啊，神也让他在异象里面看到天国跟地狱。
And just now, the testimony of that little brother that we've mentioned earlier, God allowed him to see heaven and hell.
啊，那个天国啊，神让他看到天国，真的是很漂亮。
And God brought him to heaven. It was very beautiful.
啊，很荣美，就好像天圣经里面所记载的一样。
It's glorious, likened to what was recorded in the Bible.
但是比较特别的是，这个小朋友在异象里面也看到地狱。
What is special is that this little brother also saw hell in his vision.
啊，很多人掉到地狱里面。
A lot of people fell into hell.
但是他的异象里面有一点很特别。
But in his vision, there's one thing that's very special.
他看到有一些本来是真教会的信徒。
He saw some people who were initially members of the true church.
走在一个桥上面，本来要去天国的。
They were walking on the bridge that was heading towards the heavenly kingdom.
但是后来因为犯罪啊。
However, because they had sinned.
被主耶稣吹走。从那个桥掉下来，就下到地狱里面。
They were being blown off the bridge by our Lord Jesus and fell into hell.
就跟这里所讲的一模一样。
Like unto what is recorded here.
如果有拜偶像的呢
？If you worship idols.
奸淫的呢
？If you commit sexual immorality.
偷窃的呢
？If you steal.
杀人的呢
？If you murder.
如果你信了主还做这种事情，这肯定从桥里面都掉到阴间，掉到地狱里面去。
If you believe in the Lord and you still do those things, then you will indeed fall off the bridge and into hell.
所以我们要很谨慎。
So let us be careful.
在这个印象里面，那个小弟兄还看到一幕很特别。
And in his vision, this little brother saw a very special scene.
他在地狱里面本来是看到有一个年轻的小姐很漂亮。
At in hell, he saw a young woman very beautiful.
但是一进入地狱里面的那个样子就变得很恐怖，很干裂掉的样子。
But as this woman entered into hell, her face changes and her face started to dry up.
就变得很丑。
And she looked ugly.
那还有很多很多人。
And a lot of people
啊，魔鬼的就在火里面、火湖里面来啊虐待他们呢。
And the devil was boiling these people.
哇，这个里面非常的恐怖。
And it was very terrifying.
让他觉得哇，原来地狱里面圣经所描写的真的是火湖啊，那些都是真实的。
And the little brother felt that it is true that what is recorded in the Bible by hell is all true, the lake of sulfur.
那些在世上杀人的人
，the murderers of the world.
哇，在地狱里面被锯开。
They were being saw in half in hell.
然后那些在世上犯奸淫的人
，those who committed sexual immorality.
哦，那地狱里面被那个长矛刺过他的生殖器官啊。
And they were being speared through their body.
哇，看起来非常的恐怖。
It was a very terrifying sight.
这个小学生圣经不是很懂，但是神让他看到里面这些异象跟圣经记载的非常的接近。
A grade one child, he didn't understand the Bible very well, but our Lord Jesus showed him a vision of hell.
所以我们不要以为圣经讲的是天荒夜谭啊，是这些好像是小说。
Do not think that what is written in the Bible is fiction.
这每样都是真的。
Everything in here is true.
只是我们的灵眼没有被打开，没有看过这些异象。
It's just that our eyes had not been opened to see the spiritual realm.
这是主耶稣透过有看到这些异象的小朋友，或者是有一些人的见证。
It is through the testimonies of young children or members.
是我们正耶稣教会的，不是外面的。
Who had been gifted with a vision to know what is truly happening there.
但是后来主耶稣也是有带这个小弟兄看天国。
But our Lord Jesus also brought this young brother to heaven.
他看到很美的环境。
And he saw that heaven was beautiful.
但也看到他去世的阿公阿妈在那边唱诗、祷告、聚会。
And he saw his grandparents who had passed away that they were in heaven singing hymns and gathering for services.
每个人拿着金色的圣经啊，坐在那边聚会。
Everyone was holding a golden Bible and attending services.
哇，他们都长得很年轻、很漂亮。
And they all look young and beautiful.
啊，都跟主耶稣在一起。
And they were with our Lord Jesus.
这个就是启示录里面所讲的圣城的这种情况。
And this is exactly what is recorded in the Bible regarding the holy city.
啊，那异象里面有一点。
And there was another point in the vision.
他在天国里面看到他们在唱诗。
In the heavenly kingdom, the young brother saw people singing hymns.
他们唱什么诗啊
？What were they singing?
啊，那位小弟兄听到了，就是唱我们赞美诗185首。
And the little brother heard them singing hymn number 185.
四目天家。四目天家
，They were longing for the heavenly kingdom.
哇，这个就是异象里面给我们的那种信息。
So this is the message that his vision brought us.
在异象里面，天使有跟他说。
In his vision, the angel said to the young brother.
主耶稣说啊，其实世界末日已经到了。
The Lord Jesus said that the end of the world is already here.
只是很多真耶稣教会的信徒还没悔改。
It's just that a lot of members of the true church have not repented.
主再给一些时间。
The Lord is giving more time.
希望神的儿女都能够悔改，归向神。
He hoped that all his children can repent and return to him.
我读这个见证的时候非常的震撼。
When I was reading this testimony, I was stunned.
主耶稣不是说很多外面的没有信的罪人还没有悔改。
The Lord Jesus is not saying that a lot of the Gentiles haven't repented, haven't believed in the Lord yet, and they have not come to the church.
主耶稣是说，真耶稣教会里面很多人还没有真正的悔改。
Rather, in the vision, the angel said that a lot of members of our true church have not repented.
这些人不是别人，可能是你跟我。These
are not strangers; it could be you and I.
我们名字可能已经被擦了一大半了。
Our name is probably almost erased from the book of life.
如果主耶稣今天晚上来，我们都不能得救。If
our Lord Jesus were to come tonight, probably we cannot be saved.
除非我们马上悔改。Unless
we repent immediately.
立定心志，重新归向神。Be
determined to return to God immediately.
我们才能够欢欢喜喜地等待天国。Only
then we can wait with joy for His coming.
当我们看启示录做一个总结的时候，When
we take a look at Revelation and we come to a conclusion,
对于神的审判。 天国的来临啊，有两种的反应。And
to the judgment of God, there are two kinds of reactions.
一种就是很害怕，最好是神不要来，不要主耶稣不要再来。One
is fear, the best that our Lord Jesus not come at all.
来了就是坏事。Because
if He comes, terrible things will happen.
这种人就是不能得救的人。This
first type of people are the ones who cannot be saved.
但是另外一种人就不一样。A
second group is completely different.
我们看启示录22章。Let's
turn to Revelation chapter 22.
20节。Verse
20.
启示录22章20节
Revelation chapter 22 verse 20
证明这事的说是了，我必快来。阿门，主耶稣啊，我愿你来啊。
He who testifies to these things says, "Surely I am coming quickly." Amen. Even so, come, Lord Jesus.
哇，这句话是非常安慰。This
is these are comforting words.
约翰证明了这个事。And
John has proved that this happened.
写了那么多。He
has written so much.
12个重点。
There's only one important point.
就是主耶稣说，我必快来。And
that is surely I am coming quickly.
很快哦，不会改变的。He
will come quickly. It will not change.
你可能说这个讲了2000年的还没来。Perhaps
you'll be saying that he has been saying this for 2,000 years and he's still not here yet.
不要忘记哦，圣经说千年如一日，一日如千年。But
do not forget that the Bible says 1,000 years is likened to a day.
在主耶稣看来，
a day is likened to 1,000 years.
在主耶稣看来，就过了2天而已。
So in the eyes of our Lord Jesus, only 2 days passed.
反正这是很快的。In
fact, it will come quickly.
我们看的所有的应验，大部分都应验了。And
we have seen that most of the prophecies had already come true.
主耶稣已经快来了。Our
Lord Jesus is coming quickly.
好了，约翰呢？他要怎么反应？So
what is the reaction of John?
如果是我们是约翰，我们要怎么反应？If
we were John, how would we react?
主耶稣不要那么快来，我还没毕业。 我还没结婚。
Lord Jesus, don't come so soon. I'm still single.
我还没退休，我还没旅游环游世界。I'm
still working. I'm not retired yet. I haven't traveled around the world.
我们可能都祷告，主耶稣不要那么快来。So
perhaps this is the way you're praying to God for Him not to come so soon.
但是约翰呢，他跟你跟我不一样。But
John is different from you and I.
他说：“主耶稣啊，我愿你来。”He
says, "Lord Jesus, I wish you come quickly."
我真的很喜欢，很快你赶快来。
I truly hope that you will come quickly.
他不是说对世界很厌倦。It's
not that he's tired of the world.
他如果继续活在世上，就像保罗所说的，就是为了教会。If
he were to continue to live in this world, it is for the sake of the church.
如果觉得今天来就太好了。But
if the Lord were to come today, it would be wonderful.
因为他已经准备好了。Because
he is prepared.
弟兄姐妹，你准备好了吗？Brothers
and sisters, are you prepared?
你的名字在生命册上面吗？
Is your name in the book of life?
我们最后来唱185首。
Let us now sing hymn number 185.
就是那个小弟兄在异乡里面看到天国的人在聚会的时候唱的。
This is the hymn that the young brother saw the members singing in heaven.
185.
Number 185.